It's always good to identify things, but one always needs to know how much there is, because it's always easy to detect something. But what does it mean at the end of the day? We always need to turn it back into a quantitative answer. Without quantitation, it's hard to actually say to people if it's important what you've detected or not.
There was an enormous, around the world, research activity in trying to find a way to couple two fundamentally incompatible techniques, that being mass spectrometry and liquid chromatography. We called it the liquid phase, gas phase dilemma. Cracking this problem, everybody knew, was the holy grail. We thought we had something, but you're never really quite sure. We, a scientist, had to go to our joint venture partners, and the response was, this was on the lunatic fringe.
The API-3 was essentially a cobbled-together instrument based on our earlier triple-quad technologies of the TAGA 6000, where it now had an electrospray ion source, as we called it, ion spray. It was remarkable in that it was, I think it was the first electrospray LC-MS-MS system on the market. There were a lot of naysayers in the company who didn't think it would sell very well.
And what we did was went directly to people in our customer base, if you will, but in all honesty, what we were showing them looked like something that came directly out of the age of stone knives and bearskins. To all their credit, they saw through the superficial aspect. They supported us to a level of purchase orders. That put pressure on us. I mean, it got so crazy. I looked at a couple guys and I said, you're good at carpentry, I'm good at carpentry. We started to build this machine out of wood.
People loved the instruments. They were incredibly sensitive. They solved problems that had existed for decades, and that was how to measure analytes in an LC flow reproducibly and with high sensitivities and signal-to-noise ratios that just were not possible before.
One of the challenges associated with the API-3 is even though it was a very sensitive system, every 60 hours we had to recycle it and repump it down 24 hours. So you would actually have a long wasted time when you were doing the API-3 analysis.
So we had to come with a way around it. That led to a discovery of an entirely new physical principle. It was the principle of collisional focusing. And this allowed us to pump the gas away and focus beams through narrow slits and differentially pump so that we could use more conventional turbomolecular mechanical pumps instead of cryogenic pumps. To this day, 99%, if not all, atmospheric mass spectrometers on the planet today utilize that principle.